it.
Now I want you out of town by sundown, or you'll all be behind bars, and I don't mean serving cocktails.
Oh, I'm glad you clarified that for a moment.
Okay, we'll just go and say goodbye to Chuck and then hit the road, okay, Han?
Okay.
Hi, Chuck.
Hi, guys.
What are you doing?
Ricky and his rockets came by last night and broke the jukebox. I have to cancel the night.
What?
I think it's about time we taught that gang a lesson. Well, come on, what's the matter with yous? I'm not qualified to teach them anything. I failed my GCSE in beating it up.
Yeah, and don't you remember what the sheriff said? If we start any more trouble, he's going to put us straight back in jail.
And he means it. A friend of mine got 6 months in the slammer for not indicating when he changed lanes.
Actually, to be fair, that is quite dangerous.
In a swimming pool?
There is no way I'm spending another night in that jail. Those bars just don't keep the draft out.
Hey, don't worry, guys. Dad and I'll get by. Hey, do you guys want some fries before you go?
No, we better be going.
I'm sorry, did you say fries?
So how did this feud start then?
Well, Ricky's dad, Dickie, and I used to be good friends. We'd go around together all the time, fishing and hunting and drinking. In fact, most activities would end in mmm. Then Dickie fell in love with this girl, Nikki. She was purdy.
Purdy?
Pretty. Oh.
Purdy as a butterfly in a field of cornflowers on a summer's afternoon. She had blue eyes, bluer than a whippoorwill's wing in a clear sky over a green meadow. Only blue.
Dad, I'm getting a little hokey.
Oh, sorry, son. Anywho, Nikki fell for me instead of Dickie. And she broke his heart. Ever since then, Ricky and Dickie have been trying to put me out of business.
Sounds tricky.
And what happened to Nikki?
We got married. We had Chuck. Then she ran off with a car salesman.
Called Mickey.
No, Jim. Oh. Yeah, she ran off faster than a speeding bullet from the Lone Ranger six-shooter on a Friday evening.
Dad, that's enough. Don't get upset.
Okay.
I think we should do something to help them.
Well, like what?
Well, like, take over the place tonight and do a gig.
Yeah, but what about the sheriff?
Oh, the sheriff can pop off. Are we in or out?
Isn't this great, Dad?
It sure is. I haven't had this much fun since your mom first put mustard and ketchup on my weenie and slammed it in a bun.
Nothing's wrong, ain't nothing to prove.
Nothing to prove.
Nothing to prove. Don't need no cash, just bring a friend. Yeah, cause we gonna party all night again. One can make a party, two's not enough to get down. Three, you still get lonely, cause tonight's the night for crowds. You can make it better, we have a little bit too. Us and you together, there ain't nothing we can do.
Help us get this started,
cause it's time to call your friends.
Everyone's excited,
cause it's Friday night again.
We'll spend the whole time grooving,
just like you do.
Cause what we really like is to party on Friday night.
School's out.
we've got to get to LA.
But look on the bright side. At least you've got 40 years to do it in.
That's 50 miles per year.
Great. Plenty of bathroom breaks.
Hannah.
Hello. So much I want to say to you. Goodbye.
Are you okay?
Yeah. It's just, if I ever see Chuck again, people are 60 years old.
So, after a couple of weeks with you, that's how all your boyfriends look.
What's that?
I don't know, but I've definitely heard of it before.
This is impossible. We've come back to exactly the same place.
Well, don't look at me. Paul's navigating.
Well, it's not my fault. There's no A to Z for the Twilight Zone.